हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू AARS बायोलॉजिकल पैराडाइज। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ए न्यू चैप्टर व्हिच इज मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग एंड आल्सो मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑर्गन ऑफ आवर ह्यूमन बॉडी, दैट इज कॉल्ड हार्ट। यू नो हार्ट, इट इज अ कॉनिकल मस्कुलर पंपिंग ऑर्गन। It helps to supply the blood to the all parts of the body. This heart structure was first described by Raymond D. Wissens in 1706. The heart is made up of a special type of muscles that is called cardiac muscles. Where the heart is located? Actually, we say location of the heart is in thoracic cavity. Still exactly you can say where the heart is present, in the mediastinum. Then what is mediastinum? It is a gap between the two lungs. So heart located in mediastinum. Mediastinum nothing but a gap between the two lungs. This is the location actually. So what is the weight? You know the weight of a adult heart, just 300 gram only, the size of heart roughly. Next we will see the internal structure and external features of heart. Especially you know that heart is a muscular organ made up of cardiac muscles, and this heart is covered by a membrane, a double wall membrane, that is called pericardial membrane. This pericardial membrane gives protection to the heart. This wall of the heart actually has three layers. One, the epicardium, the uppermost layer. Second, the myocardium, the middle layer. The third one is called endocardium, the inner layer. These three layers are present in the wall of the heart. In between the three layers, there is a space. This space is called pericardial cavity. This cavity has a fluid that is called pericardial fluid. This pericardial fluid again gives protection to the heart from various shocks during movement. And internally, if you see the heart structure, we know very well about it has four chambers. These four chambers, out of these, two chambers are upper in position, two chambers are lower in position. The upper position, upper chambers, it is called atrium, otherwise you can say auricles. The lower chambers, two chambers, it is called ventricles. When you see the structure of auricles and ventricles, the auricles chambers are small when compared to ventricles. And one more difference is there between the auricles and ventricles, that is, the wall of the ventricles always thicker than the auricles. This thickness of ventricles, because of the presence of papillary muscles, here we can see the external features of the heart. From heart various blood vessels arises, and some blood vessels goes to the heart. Now you can see the shape of the heart here. So conical, inverted conical shape. So we will discuss in detail about the internal structures also. In this, let us see the internal structure of heart. So in this diagram, we see the upper chambers. It is called right atrium and left atrium. the lower chambers, they are called right ventricle and left ventricle. So in these diagrams, various blood vessels, arises, especially aorta. This aorta arises from the left ventricle, which is the largest blood vessels in the body. Whereas in the right auricle, some blood vessels carries deoxyntil blood. The name is superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. At the same time, left auricle receives blood, especially oxygenated blood, from lungs by four pulmonary veins, and right ventricle gives a blood vessel that is called pulmonary artery, which carries deoxygenated blood to the lungs to eliminate the carbon dioxide. So if you see the structure of heart, four chambers has four types of blood vessels. So to make this clear, so which blood vessels arises from which chambers of the heart, let us discuss a short method to understand the concept. Now I want to draw a diagram which is very helpful to you to understand the internal features of heart very easy, and is very interesting also. But this diagram is not, you cannot draw the diagram in the examination, but only the understanding concept, to understand the structure. I make it very simple to you to understand the various features of internal structure of heart. Now you will see that. So just imagine, we know that four chambers. So these four chambers, but it was a conical shape. But I am going to draw that diagram in this manner. I think it is easy to you to understand. Just to follow me. So how many chambers are there? Four chambers. So just make a diagram. So four chambers, the upper chambers called atrium. Already I told that atriums are small when compared to ventricles. So upper chamber is small when compared to ventricles. So these two upper chambers are called atrium. Now you can say this is right auricle, this is left auricle. So the lower chambers, it is called a right ventricle, this is left ventricle. So four chambers are completed. You know that here you can see these two auricles, right auricle and left auricle. It was completely separated. It was completely black by septum. That septum is called interauricular septum. So because it is present between the two auricles, inter, so it is called interauricular septum. You can say interauricular septum. I think it is very clear. So here the lower part, that is called ventricles. Again the ventricles has one more barrier, one more septum. So now this septum, it separates the two ventricles completely. It was completely black. There is no passage at all. Now this septum is called, it is present between the ventricles. So it is, you can say interventricular septum. Here I told interauricular septum between auricles. Here I will say these two septums, that is interauricular septum and interventricular septum, helps to avoid the mixing of oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. There is no passage at all between these two auricles. Here also there is no passage between the two ventricles, so that the blood will not mix with the other compartment. It is totally black. Now next we will see that between right auricle, you can see that between right auricle and right ventricle, there is one more septum. This septum is called auriculoventricular septum. Why it is called auriculoventricular septum? It was present between auricle and ventricle, so it is called auriculoventricular septum. Here also one more septum is there between left auricle and left ventricle. This also called auriculoventricular septum. But these two septums are totally different from other septums, because this septum has an opening. This septum has an opening, whereas there is no opening in the right atrium and left right ventricle. So this opening in the atrioventricular septum, this opening is called auriculoventricular aperture. Here also auriculoventricular aperture. So what is auriculoventricular aperture? The atrioventricular septum has an opening. This opening is called atrioventricular aperture, but this opening is guarded by a valve. This valve is made up of three flaps. Because of this three flap structure or three cusps structure, now this valve is called tricuspid valve. Again here between left auricle and left ventricle, this aperture also guarded by a valve, heart valve, but this valve is made up of only two flaps, so this valve is called bicuspid valve. Otherwise you can say mitral valve. So here we are studying about the two valves. One valve is called tricuspid valve between right auricle and right ventricle, and one more valve is called bicuspid valve between left auricle and left ventricle. This valve, the main function is it allows the blood from right auricle to right ventricle and left auricle to left ventricle, but it won't allow the backflow of blood. So this is the most important functions of the heart valve. So this heart valves are mainly to allow the blood from atrium to ventricle, that's all. So next we will see here one more thing I want to explain. So this is atrium, this is ventricles. So this wall is made up of, already I told, that pericardial membrane. This membrane of the heart wall always thickest or thicker in ventricles when compared to auricles. So here also walls are there, here also walls are there, but here what happens, the ventricles walls are always thick when compared to atrium. This thickness of ventricle wall because of papillary muscles. So here next, so far we have seen the internal structure of heart, especially four chambers, right auricle and left auricle, right ventricle and left ventricle. These two auricles are separated by a septum. It is called intra-auricular septum, whereas this is called intra-ventricular septum. But here also a septum is there between right auricle and right ventricle. This septum is not completely black. It has an opening. This opening is called atrioventricular aperture, and also here also an atrioventricular aperture is there. But this opening is guarded by a special valves. Here from right auricle and right ventricle, tricuspid valve is present. Why it is called tricuspid? It has three flap-like structures. Here from between left auricle and left ventricle, it is called bicuspid. Otherwise you can say mitral valve. Why it is called bicuspid? It has two flaps only. So apart from that, some other valves are there in the heart. That we will discuss the valves of heart. So totally in heart there are six types of valves. Six type of valves. One, bicuspid. Two, tricuspid. We know very well about bicuspid and tricuspid. And the third is aortic semilunar valve. So this aortic semilunar valve, which is present between the left ventricle and the left ventricle. Here, this is the left ventricle. Here from left ventricle there is some blood vessels arises, one blood vessel. This blood vessel is called aorta. So aorta is the largest blood vessels in the body, which arises from the left ventricle. This is the one more important key questions which has asked several time needs. And one more important blood vessels which opens from right ventricle, this blood vessel is called pulmonary artery. It's called what? Pulmonary artery. So now we are going to discuss two blood vessels arises from the right ventricle and of the left ventricle. So left ventricles opens into aorta, the largest blood vessels, and from right ventricles one more blood vessels arises. This is called pulmonary artery, which goes to the lungs, which carries deoxygenated blood. So these two arteries, aorta and pulmonary artery, guarded by a semilunar valve. So that is called, in aorta it is called aortic semilunar valve, whereas in the pulmonary artery it is called, the fourth one is called pulmonary semilunar valve. So fourth one is pulmonary semilunar valve. So it looks like a semilunar shape. So this is called, because of the shape, it was named as semilunar valve. One is present in the aortic blood vessel, one is present in pulmonary artery blood vessels. So fourth valves are there. One more valve is there, it is called fifth valve. That is valve that is called Eustachian valve. Eustachian valve. So this Eustachian valve present between pulmonary artery and this Eustachian valve present in right atrium. It present in right atrium, especially in the opening of inferior vena cava. The one more valve is, that is called sixth one, that is called Tibetian valve. This Tibetian valve, otherwise we can say coronary valve. This is present again in right atrium. This also present in right atrium. Whereas guards the opening of coronary sinus. So This valve present in coronary sinus blood vessels. So this eustachian valve present in the inferior vena cava. So once again, I want to explain the six type of valves which is present in the heart. So what are the six valves? One is bicuspid. This bicuspid present between the right auricle. Here you can see right auricle and right ventricle. And one more present that is called bicuspid. That is called left auricle and left ventricle. And the third one is aortic semilunar valve, which is present in the aorta. Fourth one is pulmonary semilunar valve, which is present in the pulmonary artery. And the fifth one is eustachian valve. It is present in the right atrium, especially here two blood vessels are there. One is from superior part of the body, superior vena cava, and one is from inferior part of the body. This is called inferior vena cava. So here inferior vena cava, it has one more valve is there. This valve is called